Where you want to go now, Ann? We got Stalker Patti outside with an awful hairdo.
I wouldn't mind finding out where the hell my $200 went.
Awful pale thighs.
She's just a mess.
Let's get her in here real fast.
Yeah, come on. In and out.
You know what I was thinking this weekend?
What?
It's time to cut her loose.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Her time is coming, guys. Patti?
Yes?
We're going to cut you loose soon.
I think we're just going to cut you loose from the show. You know what I mean?
There's not much else we can do with you.
Yeah.
You know?
Would you let us behead you?
Patti, what else would you let us do to you? Because we're really thinking of cutting you loose, finally. We've exploited you as much as we can.
Yeah.
We've gotten rid of your nip hair. We've fixed your feet.
Your feet. We shaved your head.
You felt up for the first time.
You're welcome.
And down.
And down by Ron Jeremy. The first time your patch was ever touched. We've shaved your head twice now. What else could we do to you?
Yeah.
Unless you're willing to, like, lose your virginity or something, I think we're going to cut you loose.
Yeah. You want to maybe do that?
I want to be a friend of the show.
Well, some people can't be anymore. I think you wear out your welcome a little.
But I love you all.
No, you don't. You're infatuated. You're it's exciting to be here. It's exciting to walk out in front of thousands and thousands of people and have them cheering and know who you are and stuff, but...
You're starting to think that we're really your friends, and I got to tell you, we're just not. We're just...
This isn't anything about friendship.
It's just using you for good radio.
Yeah, but I think we've run our course, and, you know, you might have a limited time with Ron and Fez, but after that, you know, it's pretty much over, Patti.
There was a time we had to cut Dan from Hoboken loose, and, you know, he moved on to the Ron and Fez show. I think we're going to cut you loose soon.
We're going to have to cut you loose, Patti. Yeah.
Unless you can come up with something else we could do.
But I'm very loyal to the station, and I'm very loyal
to the station's
show. Wonderful.
The show is just the show. It's nothing about loyalty. It's just about, I don't think there's anything else we can do with you.
Yeah, when it comes down to it, Ann and I are big businessmen now, and we have no use for you anymore.
See, it's not about friendship. And
let's just put it this way. You're like... you're like a cassette player, mm-hmm. and Ant and I are now looking for like an iPod. Can you pull off your wig so it makes it even more uncomfortable?
Yeah, Patti, pull your wig off. Keep it off. Put it on the console for a little while we just rag you. So, Patti, we really don't see anything else you can do for this program. We'll make sure, you're compensated for what you did, and that's it. I think it's over.
Jim, what's wrong?
This is really bugging me. Look, how about if she just promises not to pull her pants up like William Frawley anymore?
Hey, Rick.
Yeah, Patti, your pants are all the way up to your...
What is that?
Just stop with the Fred Merch pants. Just, you know...
Hey.
You can't boot her, man.
Patti, what else can we do to you?
Got any ideas?
It's all about ratings, and we're feeling like we're not getting the big ratings with you anymore.
Yeah. Not really working out, you know?
You gave us some good times and some lofts. We lofted.
Yeah, but I don't think there's much left for you here, and I think it's time you moved on, and we all moved on.
I think, you got to leave on top, and having your head shaved in front of, over 7,000 people on Saturday is a good way to end your career with the Opie and Anthony show.
It's a retiring... event right there that you can then retire on. It's okay. I see your lip quivering. It's okay to cry. It's, you know, it's a lot of big sports figures do that when they retire and they know they're going to be out of the public eye.
You want to leave on an up note. Willie Mays should have never played with the Mets.
Did he?
Yeah, he did. I think he was like 48 years old.
Tom Seaver's comeback was a disgrace.
Maybe we could just put Patti in a little train car and Liam Neeson could shoot water on it with a hose.
I can't see keeping around anymore.
Yeah.
Keeping her around anymore.
So, Patti?
But I don't want to lose contact with anybody. I want to stay friendly with
you. You never were friendly or had contact with us. This is just, it's business.
It's all about just getting big ratings.
Has nothing to do with the personal and enjoying one's company.
Did we ever go out to dinner with you?
Did we ever invite you over our house?
Did we ever share a drink with you?
We ever get you a card?
There's a lot of...
When all of us went to happy hour after a show or something, were you invited?
Did you go to any after parties for any of these events you show up at?
No.
No, see, it's... We're not your friends, Patti. We're just
were you
people
ever invited
on a
to
show?
Paisanos with the rest of the gang?
No, I've never gone with anyone.
See, it's, there's a reason for that, Patti. You got to understand, it's because we're not your friends. We're
when
we're
everyone
a
else,
show.
When everyone else was being limoed around from gig to gig and you had to take the bus?
Yeah.
I didn't mind that at all.
Well, it just shows you that we are a show and you are, you know, a limited commodity for that program for a limited time. And now, you know, it's over. Your expiration date has been met. And
I mean, how many times can we shave your head?
Yeah.
Two's enough.
We did it twice, so I don't see this going any further, Patti. I think you're done with this program.
I think you're done with the station in general.
With the station. I think we're going to have to say something that...
We're going to have to pass this along to Ron Fez.
Yeah. And I...
No! Stop. No.
What are you doing? Don't
what are you
give
doing
her any more money.
Are you money to
he
give
wasn't
her?
Giving her money. He's just saying how he can't pay his goddamn rent and
no,
credit card.
He feels guilty and he's going to give her money. Why are you giving her money?
I'm giving her nothing.
You are going to give her money.
I will not give, no.
What is bothering you about this?
I don't like it. But no, I will not give Patti money.
Oh, look at he doesn't like it.
No, why?
He's getting a little shaky about this whole thing.
Because they look like twins now, that's why.
So, Patti, would you have a problem with us instructing Ken Stevens and everybody else that you're no longer...
I want to be your friends. I don't want to lose contact with anybody.
We're not your friends.
You
didn't what?
Look, she sounds like Cheswick when McMurphy was leaving.
I've always been very loyal.
Doesn't matter. That's a good thing, but, you know, time has come and... And it's time, I think it's time you moved on. I think the show and the station is affecting your life. I think it'd be better for you in the long run. You'll look back and say, you know, that was probably the best move I could have made is being cut loose from the program. Now I could find a job that I don't have to worry about listening to a show, you know? You got to agree deep down, right, Patti? Behind your tears, behind the tears,
you'll move on.
But I don't want to lose anybody.
You don't have anybody.
You'll realize you're not losing much when you turn around and walk away.
You'll make real friends.
People that really care about you.
Not people that just use you.
But I had such a good time.
Had. Very, very important that you said had.
I still want to have a good time.
Well,
isn't it true you can't have a job because you can't stop listening to the radio?
That's true, isn't it?
You are a loser.
I have a job.
You cannot have a job between 3 and 11.
I do have a job.
Because you listen to us and Ron and Fez.
Oh, she also listens to Pharrell. She drives the morning show crazy in the morning. They all complain about what a pain in the ass she is.
Do you do that?
Ben's been waiting for this day for a long time.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Ben. Say everything you have been saying in the back office. Go ahead.
I'm saying it all.
Right to her face. Right there. Look her in the eye. Her lip is quivering.
You are a complete loser, Patti. You drive everyone around here crazy. You're driving the morning show, guys. All they do is complain when we get in the morning about you. Washing your hair, when you used to have your hair, in the disgusting bathroom over there.
What's wrong, Norton?
Norton doesn't like this. He's really upset.
What's the problem?
Are you okay, Jimmy?
I'm fine, yes. Yes. It's not bad.
You've been doing karaoke and stuff on Ron and Fez, right?
Yeah, but...
So that was good, but...
But you can't even do that anymore.
Yeah, I know. That's what we're saying. We're pretty much... I think it's better for you that you know...
A lot of people are very pissed off on the phone lines, Anthony. This is called tough love.
It's tough love, right.
We got to push her out the door so she could get a life.
So, you know the security guys downstairs, Patti? We're going to have to...
Well, they've been instructed not to let you through anymore.
We're
changing the codes.
We're
going
to have to tell you that. They've been instructed that...
And if you've noticed, we got a couple moving guys that are removing the couch you've been sleeping on under the stairs.
Yeah.
How about one round of bukkake before Patti leaves?
But I don't...
Good luck.
Patti, would you be up for a round of bukkake?
I don't know what that is.
No, you know, she looks like the glasses. Private Joker, show me your war face.
Could you just say, that's a negative, Rafter Man? Sir, I said it, sir!
Patti, at least you have the memories, right?
Right, you have good memories, right? That's all you need. Just think of us as a loved one that passed on. But you have the good memories, but you know that you'll never, ever, ever see them again. Right?
But I didn't... What
Patti?
Did I do?
Patti, you have 2 minutes to say goodbye to your fans.
I don't
want to
say
goodbye.
Here it is.
Now.
Regardless of what you say,
2 minutes.
This is your final 2 minutes. on WNEW.
Why are you doing that?
And all the other stations we broadcast to. Say goodbye to your fans, Patti.
But
shut up, Jimmy, with your fake effing morality.
I just because she looks like Tim Robbins in Jacob's Ladder, I don't think she should be voted.
A Jacob's Ladder reference, nice.
Yeah,
Lewis Black is in
there. I know, what you thinking, Lewis?
Can I start the music again? Patti, you really have 2 minutes.
Say hi to Sigourney Weaver on that penal colony from Alien 4.
Can we give Patti her 2 minutes?
I don't want
to. All right, here's
your
talk.
2 minutes.
I don't.
Starting, hold on. Starting now, you
here's
get
your 2 minutes.
To say goodbye to everyone.
Say goodbye to everyone.
I don't want
to
say goodbye to anybody.
Just because she has a body and head like a 2-day-old sparrow, that's no reason to
blame. I didn't do anything so wrong.
Jim, hold on, Patti.
Patti, it's nothing about what you don't want to happen. This is happening. Now, just use this 2 minutes to say goodbye.
Anthony
to
and I, we have to
audience.
Make tough decisions from time to time.
It's called tough love.
And we truly believe that your time has come and gone.
This is better for you and your life. So 2 minutes. Don't complain. Don't do anything. Say goodbye to your fans.
Well, she can do whatever she wants with the 2 minutes.
All right.
This will be the last 2 minutes of radio that Stalker Patti does.
Here it is.
I don't understand where you're coming from. I didn't talk in the dugout or to maybe say 2 words. I'm a quiet person. I didn't say anything. I don't understand.
Look, just because she has toes like macadamia nuts, there's no reason to toss her off the radio.
Jim.
Look, I don't think the Dudley Moore feet should be thrown out.
Jim, please. We want Stalker Patti to say goodbye.
Patti, just say goodbye to your fans.
Did you enjoy your 15 minutes of fame?
It lasted a while. You had a good run.
Dean,
it's over, though.
Dean from D.C. wants to know. You had a longer radio career than Mason and Kalinske.
Right.
In New York, so that's something to be proud of.
Yeah.
You can act like a man. What's the matter with you?
Come on, Patti.
You lasted longer in New York City radio than Tom Likas.
Yeah.
Put the wig on. At least have a little bit of dignity through this whole thing.
No, we like with the wig off.
Yeah.
All right. Patti, I'm sorry that Jim Norton keeps interrupting you. You got 2 minutes to say goodbye to everybody in this room and to your fans.
Last time you're going to be here.
I don't want to say goodbye.
We never all want to say goodbye.
I didn't do anything. I don't understand.
Look, she's shaking like she's starring it on Golden Pond. This is not right.
Jim, we just want to get through this. It's very uncomfortable for everybody. We don't feel good about this. We just know it's good for the show that we get rid of Stalker Patti.
Patti, you keep saying you didn't do anything. It's not about doing anything. Yeah. It's what we've done. We can't. There's nothing more you can do.
I mean,
that's what it is. It's over. Accept it.
We can't think of anything else to do with you after getting your head shaved in front of 7,000 people
right.
on Saturday.
So get over it and use this time now, 2 minutes.
Anthony and I are marketing geniuses, and we know when to say goodbye to
someone. We know.
Okay, so
we feel it, and it's done.
So please, you got 2 minutes to say goodbye to everybody. This will be the last time you see all our faces. And 2 minutes to say goodbye to the listeners that support you. All right, and if Jimmy will shut up, your 2 minutes begins now.
I love everybody. I don't want to say goodbye to anybody. I love everyone. I like to keep friendships.
All right, listen, Lou Gehrig. There's no reason to be making this speech.
You know,
I'm the luckiest gimp on the face of the earth.
Jim.
Patti,
I'm sorry.
This is only prolonging her agony,
We
Jim.
Want her to leave with dignity.
We just want her to get her two minutes.
Her 2 minutes to say all her goodbyes.
Turn her back. And, Patti, when the time does come, when you do finally get this 2 minutes, as long as Jim shuts up, you will turn around. You will walk out that door. Walk to the elevators. Take it down. Don't look back. And never, ever come up to this floor. Or in this building, actually, again, Patti.
And please end with your mom's box, okay?
Yeah.
Hold on. Here's your two minutes.
Here it comes.
To say what you need
here
to
it
say.
Comes.
You know, tomorrow was my birthday, and I had...
And it still is your birthday.
Yeah, and I was going to come up to Ron and Fez and visit for my birthday.
Wow. No, we have we have made a deal with Ron and Fez and Scott Farrell. We all believe this is the right thing to do.
We all sat in a
You will
in
notice
a meeting.
This radio station here in New York is moving forward. We're getting rid of some dead weight.
Out with the old, in with the new is the motto
That's
around
right.
here.
All right.
Patti. And we talked with Pharrell. We talked with Ron and Fez. And we thought it would be best for you also if, you know, you were just banned from coming up here and you could get on with your life. Because this station is becoming like a drug for you that you're addicted to. And you need to quit it cold turkey. So we're trying tough love. And we're banning you from the building here. And... you have 2 minutes now to say goodbye, and this is it. Just say goodbye.
Right, and please say something nice about Aunt and I, because I think we've done a lot of nice things for you. Okay?
All right, here we go. 2 minutes.
I loved the show since August of 1998.
Can you separate your teeth a little when you talk?
Jim.
I've been,
Hold on.
Sorry. What?
Jim, you're just prolonging her agony. She's very upset about this, and we can all see it. She's quivering. Her lip is moving, and there's tears welling up in her eyes. And she understands that this is the last time she's going to say anything on these microphones, the last time she's going to be in here on any show, and she's going to go back to obscurity, what her life was before, and just try to get along now with her own life without this station being a part of it.
And, Patti, could you do it topless for us, please?
Wrong with you.
How about if she promises to do something just so she doesn't have the facial structure of Richard Widmark?
Jim, it's her 47th birthday tomorrow, so let's hear her out, okay?
Oh, happy birthday.
All right. Patti, 2 minutes to say goodbye. There's a lot of people that you should thank, okay? All right, here we go. Mm-hmm.
I've been a big fan since August 98. I met you Thanksgiving of 98 when I worked for a charity that did an event up here. And I got to know you through the last 3 years. I don't want it to be goodbye. I want to be able to come to a road show and say hello to you all and be like a friend, you know. I've done nothing but support everybody. I haven't been a pest or anything. I'm not obnoxious. I'm a very quiet, low-key kind of a person. I don't know what this is all about. You know, even if I could just remain a friend of the show, you know, without, you know, you doing anything to me, it would be, you know, nice, you know. I didn't do anything wrong to anybody. I've never wronged anyone.
Patti, 1 minute to go. Start the thank yous.
But
tell everyone how great Aunt and I are.
Anthony and Opie and Anthony are really great. You know, they're one among the finest talents on the radio.
And Jim Norton, he's okay, right?
Jim Norton's great, too. He's a great comedian.
40 seconds to go.
This is it, your last 40 seconds on the air.
I do want to come up and hang tomorrow night with Ron and Fred for my birthday.
Ain't gonna happen. This is the last time you're gonna be in here. That's it. Doors open. How much time left, Opie?
We'll give her like 30 more seconds because we interrupted a little bit. Yes, Patti?
I don't want anyone to hate me. I want you to be friendly to me.
Oh, Rick's grabbing her arm. This is it, Patti. There you go. Time is up.
Is that it, Patti?
Yeah.
Turn around. Don't look back.
Right.
Here it is. The last time you're going to see this station.
Oh, wait, Patti?
Slam the door, please.
There.
Good riddance.
Oh. There it is.
The end of Stalker Patti.
Oh, you got to be tough. Got to be tough.
Oh, it's the right thing to do.
Of course it is. Opie, by the way, Jerry West is the NBA logo. It's been confirmed.
Oh, look at that.
Getting back to more important things.
Anthony, Rick is on the phone as we get her removed from the building. Rick?
Yeah, hey, guys.
Hey.
Yeah, I just got the call from security. They're aware of it, and we're bringing her down now so they can take a look at her and make sure they've got all her info before they keep her out of the building.
Can we put Stalker Patti back on the air, please?
Sure.
All right.
Come on, Patti, stand up. Grab your cane.
Patti?
Hello?
It's Patti.
It's Opie and Anthony. We just want to make sure you realize this is for your own good, okay?
But I don't...
It's for your own good. This is it, Patti. It's for your own good, and you're never to come back up here again.
Why do you hate me?
Or any? It's not hatred. This is, we're helping you.
It's all about ratings, my dear. We got to move on to the next freak.
And then you get your life in order.
There's many freaks in the big city. Your time is, come and gone.
I'm not a criminal or anything.
No, it doesn't matter.
If we had some kind of a friendship that we developed over these years, then, you know, you'd still be around. But
right.
It's obvious that we were just using you for good radio, and that good radio is now over.
So,
all right.
Bye-bye, Patti.
Rick, what's going on?
Okay, we just we got downstairs to the lobby area.
Okay.
I'm going to take her to the front so the security guys know that this is the one.
All right, put her back on.
All right, hold on.
Hello?
Hey, see Patti.
Yes.
This is the last time you'll be seeing the lobby.
I don't understand.
Well,
there's not much to really understand, that's all.
Out with the old, in with the new is what we like to say. And your time here is done, Patti, so bye-bye.
You all right with this,
Patti?
Not really, because I don't fully understand.
Well, you're simple-minded.
You don't really need to understand.
Yeah. Just face it. Now you can move on with your life.
All right, yeah, come on.
Are you out the door yet?
Walking out the door now.
How many people are around you, Patti?
A few.
Could you have less pizzazz on the phone?
I don't understand it.
Well, no need to understand. It's bye-bye time. Are you outside the building now, Patti?
Yeah, outside the building.
You do understand now that you are not...
You can't stay.
You are not to come back in the building, right?
You're not even allowed to hang out in the courtyard anymore like you used to before we invite you up here for the first time.
But you're acting like I'm a very dangerous person.
No, it's just time to move on, Patti. Bye-bye. You understand? Bye-bye. Okay?
What?
It's over.
Here, I don't want to talk anymore.
No, she doesn't talk anymore.
Why doesn't she want to talk anymore?
What's the matter? Why don't you want to talk anymore, Patti?
It's not right.
She says it's not right.
Oh, it's right. Sure it is.
I've been a very good fan of the show. I've been very loyal. I always support you.
Oh, get a hold of yourself.
I'm...
What's... Rick?
Hello?
What's going on?
Well, we've got it to the corner of 57th and 7th, and that's, I guess, the legal distance. It's about, about 100 yards from our front door.
All right.
So that's where they told us to leave her.
All right. Maybe some final thoughts from Patti.
One final thought.
Patti, do you have a final thought before we walk away?
Yeah. Can I still keep in touch?
No. It's
over. Can I call
over.
In and say hello?
Nope. No. Your call will not be accepted.
I don't want to lose any friendships.
You have no friendship.
Anybody.
You have no friends here. It's over.
And Patti, just to make sure you understand, there will be a restraining order that will be presented to you.
Why?
It's just the right thing to do, to make sure you know we're serious about this one.
Why are you doing this to me?
Because it's over.
Is it because I came back to get the rest of the money or something?
It's over, Patti.
No, it's just over.
It's just over.
You have nothing more to add for us.
All right?
Oh.
Any last word for everybody?
I had a good time. I don't understand why it ends, but I had a good time.
Had. That's good that you said that.
I've been a very good fan of the show.
Yeah, but you got to move on. I mean, people aren't watching MASH anymore. You know what I mean?
Yeah, see? There's new things.
There's new things to check out. Okay? There was a time we all loved Beavis and Butthead. It's just not on TV anymore.
Patti.
Yeah, but you just don't throw people away. I didn't do anything wrong.
Bye, Patti.
Rick, why don't you take the phone away from Patti?
Bye-bye, Patti.
Hello.
All right, Rick, tell her to turn and walk away.
All right, Patti, since we can't escort you any further, you need to turn around and just walk away. That way, please. Keep going. That way.
Is she limping along with her cane?
Yep. Go. That way.
There it goes.
Oh, Rick?
Yeah.
Tell her that that's not her wig. That's
Patti, by the way.
That's property of the radio station. Please.
The radio station actually owns that wig. They've asked me to take it from you.
Pull it off her head.
No.
Yeah, I need to take it from you.
I can't. I have a job and everything, and I have to see people. It's the only thing I can hide on. So.
No, I need. They're asking me to take it because it's property of the station.
Pull it off her head, Rick. Pull it off her head.
Please.
Pull it off her head.
Don't do this to me.
Let me take the wig.
Please. I don't want anyone to see me like that. I don't want anyone to see me. I have a job and everything. Please. I don't want to see a stain. Please.
Did she wet herself yet?
Please.
Rick.
Yeah.
Take the wig.
I can't.
Take the wig.
All right. Patti, no, we have to take the wig. So if you can just... if you don't...
I don't know what I look like if I was set without it.
But if you don't hand it to me, I'll be forced to take it off your head.
Don't do it, please. I don't want anyone to see me. I can't go to work like this. I don't have anything to
take
like
the wig.
Please.
Take the wig.
All right. I've reached my limit.
Take the wig.
I've reached my limit.
Get Steve on the phone. He has the balls to take it.
All right, Patti. Relax.
I've reached my limit. Okay.
Relax. Patti.
I don't want to see Steve.
Don't worry. Just relax.
I'm out. Take the
Don't worry. Just relax. What happened to your finger, by the way?
Hey, Rick.
What is that?
Hey, Rick.
Yeah.
Make sure she
puts... can't take you to walk.
Get her all relaxed. She'll put her hands down on her side, and then you grab it and run, okay?
Oh, my
Okay, so you're fine.
Oh, no.
Okay?
Here it comes.
You can relax.
Oh, no.
You can relax. Well, just remember you have to walk in that direction, okay?
All right, Rick.
Is that okay, guys?
Yes.
All right.
Is she still holding on to the
dance? We're going to let her walk this way.
Okay. Thank you. All right, now turn and walk away.
All right.
Why did you do that?
All right,
let me walk away.
All right.
Walk.
I can't take this. Oh, my God, I can't take this.
All right, Rick, you got the wig?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
I'm going out.
All right. Thank Goodbye. You, Rick.
Oh, my God. I know where my line is now. I know where my limit is. I can't take the crying old virgin woman crying about her hair.
That's awful.
Oh, my God, that was horrid.
Sorry, guys. It's tough love.
Oh, God.
It's tough love.
Oh, you have some issues,
We knew it wasn't going to be easy.
You got some goddamn issues.
We knew it wasn't going to be easy, guys. We had to do it. You know that.
If you could bring in a puppy tomorrow, we could stab and torture.
That was like when they pulled the bag off the elephant man's head. They're staring at me.
Oh, my. She should be wearing a burlap hat with an eye cut out of the middle.
Hey, man, I don't feel good about it. You guys don't, but it's something we had to do.
You do feel
You understand
good about
that.
It.
Wow.
You guys understand that much, right, Ben? You all right with the decision?
It's the greatest thing we've ever done. Can we play
amazing.
Cool in the Gang Celebration?
Ben looks like Boston fans after the Patriots won the Super Bowl.
You just heard that little scuffle? Where she's probably her thin little fingers trying to grip at the wig in Rick's hands. Look,
They're staring at me.
We would love to go to the phones, but trust me, guys, we had to do this today. I know you want to yell and scream, but it's the right thing.
Very angry people.
Okay.